weekend was really, really action-packed. Now, the story came in for me and I was just very, very, very much confused. On Saturday at the game, now, a situation occurred, an altercation that was kind of wrong. First of all, it took me a minute to understand the whole reason why somebody was shot or could have been shot or probably was shot for is because he scratched a Nissan. A Nissan, for crying out loud. It got me very... I was flabbergasted. I was like, Wanji? But here's the question. There's so many people who are enraged, they're pissed off. How easy is it to get a gun in Uganda? As in, why doesn't the government come out, or police, or whoever is in charge of this body, whoever owns a gun in Uganda should be put somewhere among other photos so that we can know? Because how you relate with someone who owns a gun is packing heat is definitely not the same way you relate with someone who is not packing heat. And at the end of the day, there's so many things that piss me off about this story. So yes, guy has scratched your Nissan Murano. Couldn't you come out nom kuba kuba mwen people scratching a motkwanga kuba uine bikonde ne kugamba tegendo fixing it? That was enough. You could have even come out with a supposed gun, waved it at him, and he would have cowered away in pure shame and fear. But you took out your gun and shot him. It's confusing. But then there are very, very many other scenarios that we have to look at. When you're going to any supermarket or any public mall, usually at the entrance, they check you. They check your car, they check you, and then if you have any firearm, you are supposed to check it in before you can go. You leave it up with security. Why did this guy walk around in the parking lot of a mall that is clearly filled on a daily with very unsuspecting people, kids, and why was he walking around in this mall with a gun? So this guy, yes, you own a Kalito company, your chick is beautiful, it gave you reason to actually go out and get yourself a gun. Negro, bye. Thing is, at the end of the day, I can stand it. I can sit next to a police officer holding a gun and not feel scared because I know he is trained. They are trained to handle every situation. But this low-life nigga who actually pretty much, the only reason he got a gun is because his ego wasn't, you know, right there. He's trying to overly compensate for something that he lacks as a human being. He felt it needful to go and buy himself a gun. And then when he bought the gun, he offed a person who could have been as simple as, boss, I am sorry, because this guy came out to apologize. He apologizes like, banange boss, I am sorry. And then you go and click two in him, and you don't just click two in him, he's dead, nigga, he's dead. Why does Uganda nowadays make me feel like I'm in a gang-banging movie? Like, should we start walking in fear at this point? Okay, bebe kula ino mkazi wa mulunji, given this guy also a child, but dechimuaga mkazi momotoka probably. Bebe kula has a brown chick, she's beautiful. Katia na kwatachi, AK-47, RPG. What, should Bobby Wine also go and get himself a gun, pack hit because, I mean, duh, he is known. These things of every tamirikachi, tamirike are nonsense. All of those ones having guns, I just don't quite get it. For crying out loud, it's the bloody festive season and y'all is walking around giving us situations. I was just thinking of going to that supermarket. They have like the best discounts. No, I don't wanna. I don't know who is seated next to me there. Inzo kubanga ine mundu, nyizo mutu nuliro vina ankube sasi. But at the end of the day, this is what I'm going to say. I think it's time government came out, get for us these people's photos, their full names, over probably your Kariama Gundi Polo, Bakutekewo, Nechifana Nicho, Batugambe, so and so, went and bought himself a gun. This is the reason why he has a gun. Give us the name, reason as to why so and so has a gun. Let's know Bujamsi, Arjenda Naviona. You know they have those funny names. Arjenda Naviona owns a gun because he has a big house. Kayondo Samuero has a gun because he has a brown woman. Rutamirika Steven has a gun because he has low below the belt issues. Just let us know so that when we move into this situation, banange nafe tubatumanyize nyizo tunyomusajja obubi. You know mumwa gwange tegu controlling. I may just look at the guy bubi mulaini ya supermarket. Na kube sasi. Like for real, man. But besides that, welcome to Scoop on Scoop. It's a fresh new week. I told you. November and December, the crazies are out. It's like officially Halloween for the next 2 weeks. Everything crazy is going to be on these streets. But welcome. While comedians have decided to take it upon themselves to look for a certain person called Charity. Chamba denja galo kubuza nga tetunabana kola story. Who is Charity? Avera wasura kunyumba zani nga tukoyo munonya. Now that I'm done with that, comedians, a couple of comedians, not even the very big ones, with the exception of Alex Muhanji on that one, about six of them. Okumanya si, I don't even want to know their names. I did read the names. I was like, you mean this guy has also ever been on a stage? Wow. I tried Googling two of them. I'm like, hey, he did it. Okay. Anyway, they decided they're going to do a charity run all the way from Chadondo Rugby Grounds down to Yusuf Lule Road and then back to Chadondo, where they'll finally commence the whole, no, they'll end the whole shebang with a bang. They'll do a comedy show. And of course, you have to pay 20K to be a part of the walk. Now that's the part where I was like, something's fishy right here. This is fishy. Tamugenda kutuli mbambu, it is in the name of charity. Mbamagalanga Center, tell us Ugandans. We look for haha moments. We don't have what to do. We have a lot of FOMO. Other than lying to us, buliomukat yekwasa charity. Whenever you're only seated at home and you're broke, charity. Whenever you think you're not known enough, charity. Whenever you feel you have egotistical issues, charity. We are tired of you looking for this person called charity. We have held car washes. It's a very sensitive topic. But I'm damn tired of it. Look for other ways to be innovative if you want to be philanthropists. But don't come out and tell us, so what, you're going to walk and people are going to pay 20K. First of all, you didn't give us the name of the charity fund that it is going to. Secondly, why would you walk just from here up to there to raise 20K? And then after that, people are still going to come and sit and watch your comedy show and they're going to keep buying alcohol and food, which you're going to get money from. As in, don't we look that dumb? Moment in my life. Oh, Salvador Idringi, you just went ahead and did it. You just went and became your old normal self, the person that we see every day, not that guy who you keep fronting on TV, Mbu, he's nice, he's funny. No, you were drunk as a kite. Ah! This guy was so drunk. Now, all this went down over the weekend. He was in, he was at Mass, that's of course, Mbara University. He got way high, started uttering words that didn't go down well with a certain group of people, got into a fist fight, and guess who was there to clean up the mess? Oh, Chamagero. Chamagero, banaye Chamagero. You know, Chamagero reminds me of those loyal dogs. You know, like that loyal puppy that loves you. Like, if you stand on the side, you're like, Chama, Chama, Chama. Chama, Chama, Chama. You kept cleaning up this guy's dirty work, and for some reason, the only thing you get from him is being around him. So I'm watching the clip, I'm listening to the audio, and poor Chamagero ya muliko. Look it out, tobavuma tugende, tugende. At this point, Chamagero is going to end up taking over all of Salvador's work. Because, I mean, what kind of loyalty is this? Isn't this nonsense? Isn't this is what my grandfather used to say. A man needs to have a spine. Chamagero, grow a spine, and while you're at it, grow a pair. Look for your own shine. You are a radio host, TV host. Yeah, you don't need to be with Salvador. And I bet Salvador, in this whole fight, he was like, do you know who I am? I have a brown wife. I have two kids. I ignore basket mouth. Who do you think you are? Do you know me? Chamagero is also just standing there like, yes, he's Salvador. He knows basket mouth. Chamagero, really? I'm just saying, grow a pair, boy. Come and try to look for your own shine. You'll get it. That's the funny thing. You'll get it. I really believe that if Chamagero stood on his own, this is like the myth Navio situation. When the myth is standing with Navio, you can never know the myth can actually rap. No. But when the myth stands away from Navio, he can drop a sick, ill rhyme. You'll be like, why do we follow Navio when the myth is this good? Now that's the same thing with you, Chamagero and Salvador. We are never going to know your worth, your potential, your value if you keep walking around this guy who clearly isn't your best friend. No, he likes basket mouth more. Oh, today has been one extremely heated day. In the morning, I wake up and I decide to just peruse through Ugandan television, find out what's happening on the local scene, and I guess who I chance upon. Doreen Chomhanj. This girl actually speaks Lunglish. Buchimanyacho. Omana yabandayo gero luzungu, but it sounded like Luganda. I was like, how did this chick get on national television? Why is she doing a current affairs show? Because she looks so clueless. I think when she bleached the little brains that were left in her, but she is a brand in you. It just goes to say, Ugandans, we don't know what we want. I looked at the chick. Ayogera, biayogera, sibitegera. They don't make sense, but every man watching the show is just like this. Yeah.
True. For real? Anyway, I think she reminds me that if you want a good job in Uganda and you're light-skinned from Barara, have no plans in life, lay down flat, you'll get a promotion. Besides that, it's been a good day. My name is Tina. Catch me again tomorrow at TinaFierce1 is the Twitter handles. For all the Twitter trolls out there, please bring it on. I'm itching for a good battle on Twitter. And besides that, you can get me on Facebook. That's, of course, the Scoop on Scoop Facebook page. Do not forget, I repeat, to like. Do not forget. Or the Urban TV Facebook page. For now, I'm out. Peace.